Say, kids, what time is it? Yes, sir, and all my boys and girls here in Dutyville, kids in Albany, and all over America, let's go! Kids, well, I don't have to tell you what all the fancy decorations are for. Because, ho ho, kids, in just a little while, it's going to be New Year's Eve.
Yeah, yes, Happy New Year! Happy New Year, everybody!
Mr. Cobb, Happy New Year, but it's not quite yet. Not yet.
Not yet?
No.
Sorry?
Yeah, you see, kids, in just about 6.5 hours, it's going to be New Year's Eve for moms and dads. But, of course, you boys and girls are going to be asleep then. But say, just for you boys and girls, Howdy Doody is having a very special New Year's Eve much earlier.
Oh, that's fine. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
Yes. Mr. Cotton, not quite yet. Oh, not this early, see?
Oh, I see.
Now, look, boys and girls, the kids' New Year's Eve is going to ring out in about, I'll see, about 26 minutes. So you're just going to have to wait.
Sorry, Buffalo. Sorry. Right.
Yeah, but Buffalo Bob, you know, we could start giving out some of the gadgets now. Because kids, oh boy, we've got noisemakers and we've got horns and party hats for all of you.
I'll take my party hat right now, please, Buffalo.
Now wait a minute. You've got to be patient. Look, boys and girls, we've got some little party hats and we've got some nice horns. Listen. Yes, sir, that's for all of you kids a little later. And besides all those things for you, look what we've got here. We've got some larger party hats, 4 of them. One for Mr. Cobb.
Oh, boy. Oh, man, a man.
Wait a minute,
sir.
One for Mr. Cobb, one for myself, and one for our special guest, Big Ben, who's going to be here a little later. And if Clarabelle shows up, a hat also for Clarabelle. Well, we'll tell you about Clarabelle later, but
Yeah. All right, give me my hat now. Give me my hat.
All right, now look, Mr. Cobb, I know you're impatient, so look. I will give you your hat now, but...
Yeah.
I remind you, there's only one hat for each person.
Yeah.
So you've got to take good care of it.
Oh, sure.
Okay?
Sure. Goes without saying.
Oh, look at that, kid.
Snazzy, yeah.
Pretty snazzy, yeah. Now, I say you've got to take good care of it because we only have enough to go around one to a person. And, of course, those are very expensive hats.
Oh.
So I don't want you to soil them, or I don't want you to crush them,
don't do anything like this?
Yes, don't do anything like that. That's exactly what I mean. Now, look, take this hat and be careful with it, please.
Well, I'm having a wild time today,
yeah,
Buffalo.
Cornelius, do me a favor. Come back in about, 25 minutes for the celebration, okay?
Okay, Buffalo. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Mr. Cobb.
Oh, gosh.
No more news about Clarabelle, Howdy.
No, Princess, it's too bad. Boy, that silly clown Clarabelle has been on that wild horse for about 8 straight days now.
Aw, there's nothing to feel bad about. Clarabelle's all right, and the horse will stop galloping soon. Yeah. The horse has to get tired sometime.
Gee, that poor horse.
Aw, Howdy, there's nothing to feel bad about. Horses like to run.
Well, yeah, but poor Clarabelle, boy, I... Well, it looks like he's going to miss our New Year's Eve party.
Now, Howdy, there's nothing to feel bad about. If Clarabelle were here, well, what would he do?
Yeah, you're right. He'd just squirt somebody and wreck the whole party.
So let's just forget him, okay?
Okay.
And Buffalo Bob.
Oh, yes, Princess.
Say, Buffalo Bob.
Yeah?
May I have my hat now, please?
Well, you certainly may. Come on over here.
Buffalo Bob.
Yeah?
I'd like one that the kids will be wearing.
Oh, one like the kids are wearing,
uh-huh.
Huh? Well, would you say maybe one like this?
Oh, that'd be fine. I wonder if I could get it on.
A little jockey hat, huh?
Just like that?
Oh, that's cute. That's wonderful. Very good.
Bob, let's see how you look in your hat.
Well, you sit down here a minute.
All right.
And,
I think I'll...
What do you think of this one?
Oh, that's nice.
Kids, now look. Here's a hat that I'm going to wear. And there's the kind of a hat that, well, it looks so good for a New Year's Eve type party. So I figured that if I wear this hat, everything will be just great. Because I could get this hat, and then I could help.
thinking habit.
Wait a minute, mister.
Now, just a minute here.
What's the matter?
What are you doing, Cornelius Cobb?
Now, wait a minute. I'm George the Judge.
Oh, Judge Fudge, I gave you a top hat a minute ago. This one's mine.
No.
No what?
You didn't give me no hat, Buffalo. You may have given a hat to some guy by the name of J. Cornelius Cobb, but I'm George the Judge.
I know you're also George the Judge, but you're all one and the same person.
Sorry, bye.
Now, wait just a minute here. Just a minute. You're only one person. You might have two jobs, but you don't have two heads. Nobody has two heads.
I don't agree
so
with you.
So you only get one hat.
Nothing doing. Tell you what, why don't you ask the kids? Maybe they'll make up their mind for us, huh?
Well, all right, kids, how many hats do you think Mr. Cobb ought to get? One or two? One? Okay, one. There you go, Cornelia. Cornelia! Wait a minute, got away with two hats.
Buffalo.
Boys
Happy
and
New
girls,
Year, kids. Happy
Ben.
New Year, kids. Happy
Welcome,
New Year.
Welcome, Big Ben.
Hey, it's good to see you, Big Ben.
Yeah, kids, I know you all remember Big Ben because, well, Bing is a traveling circus master. And Ben ran the Howdy Doody Circus when I had to go to Japan last year, right, Ben?
Yeah, but things have changed, Buffalo Bob. The circus is gone, I see.
Yeah, oh, yes, the circus is gone. You see what happened? The city made a junk dump out of our Howdy Doody Circus, and they gave us this beautiful land here instead. The town of Dutyville.
Well, congratulations on that, Buffalo Bob. Congratulations.
Oh, gosh, but that's not all that's changed. Boy, oh boy, Ben, it certainly seems to me that you have changed, too. Why, kids, Big Ben looks like he must have lost about 100 pounds.
Why, that's right, Big Ben.
Yeah. You know, over at my circus, they call me Middle-sized Ben now.
Middle-sized Ben. Well, I'm certainly glad that you could come to our New Year party celebration. Say, would you like a party hat?
No, thanks. You see, I don't need one. I've got my own right here.
Yeah, well, okay. All right, fine. I just thought I...
No, listen, I'll tell you what I'd like to do.
Yeah?
I'd like to go out and tune my bell. So I'll see you later, Buffalo.
All right, you go right
ahead.
Happy
New Year. Happy New Year, kids.
He's a great guy, Big Ben.
Oh, it's so good to see him, Buffalo Bob.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute, kids. Someone's at the door now. Hello? Who's there?
It's Scotty the mailman.
Well, hello, Scotty.
Hello. Wait a minute. I got a surprise for you, Buffalo.
Scotty the mailman.
Surprise.
Oh, I'm calling now.
Well, yes, Scotty. What's the surprise?
Oh, am I here in time for the party?
Yes, your time. Now, wait a minute, Scotty the mailman. Now, look. You're here in time for the party. I know that you may be Scotty the mailman, but
you are not... Yeah, well, good. Then I'll get my hat.
Now, wait a minute. You're not going to get any hat.
What's the matter with you?
Now, look. I know that you're J. Cornelius Cobb, and I know that you're George the Judge. And I know that you've already taken two hats. But don't tell me that you've got three heads, because you're not going to get a third hat.
Oh, Buffalo, I got a letter for you.
Oh.
I got a letter way down in the bottom of the bag.
A letter?
You get it.
Maybe this is for my mother, Buffalo Emma.
Oh,
you get it, Buffalo.
Let me see. Where
is it? Down, put your head in there. Happy way down in the bottom of the bag.
Oh, way down?
Way under all the other letters, boy, Buffalo. Way down in the bottom, Buffalo. Way down in the bottom. Hey, get it. That's the one with the perfume on it, Buffalo. Hey, boy, Buffalo. That's the way, Buffalo.
Wieners. Happy New Year. What's the matter with him?
Oh, Buffalo Bob, that's three hats that he's got.
I know.
Kids, you know what? I better guard your hats during the movie so he doesn't take them. Is that all right?
That's a good idea.
Okay.
You watch him, will you please?
I will.
As a matter of fact, I'm going to take my last hat, put it on my head right now, and now I'll have it, huh?
Okay, Buffalo Bob.
Kids, would you like to see an old-time movie?
Yeah.
Okay, old-time movie. Yes, sir. Well, kids, we got a very good one for you. Yes, sir, a very good old-time movie with our buddy, Mickey who? Mickey Maguire. Yes, sir. Kids, you know, Mickey loves animals. However, Mickey was frightened by this animal. This was a bulldog. It just seemed to be running wild. Actually, the bulldog really liked Mickey Maguire, but... Well, you know, Mickey didn't know whether the dog was wild or whether he was a friend of his, so Mickey started to run. So Mick ran back to Tooneyville, and the little doggy right after him. So Mickey just can't shake the dog, and well, he's amazed the doggy wasn't after him. He just wanted to love him. So Mickey says, well, great. Come on, doggy. You and I are going to be real buddies. So Mickey got an idea. He said, well, now look. He said, I have this very nice bulldog. He said, maybe we could get a few other animals together and have sort of a menagerie. Maybe someday have a circus. So all the kids go around trying to find every kind of animal that's possible. Look, here's little Freddy. Oh, he's gonna bring a duck to the party. Well, kids, in just a few more minutes now, we're gonna have our own New Year's Eve celebration. So anyway, Freddy says, here, little fella. Here, whoa, and Freddy's got him. Look at the strong duck, huh? So McGuire says, well, look here, we got a duck, we've got a dog, and it so happens, kids, that a circus was in town and the elephant got loose. And lo and behold, if the elephant didn't walk right into the Doodyville clubhouse. So McGuire says, someone gave me an elephant for my birthday. Say, I could maybe make a pail of lemonade and start my own circus. So now, Davy Davis is watching, and he says, uh-huh. We won't let McGuire start a circus. We'll give him trouble right now. He says, you know, kids, elephants go crazy when they see a mouse. So Davy Davis shows the elephant this little white mouse. And the elephant becomes very frightened and starts running away with the Tooneyville clubhouse. Down through the middle of the street he goes. And of course, Mickey and the gang are inside the clubhouse. They have to keep a running because there's no floor on it. Watch this, kids. Oh, the automobiles see that clubhouse walking down the street. They can't understand it. So here's a man who was fixing his automobile. All of a sudden, the automobile started to go. He thought it was ghosts. So finally the elephant stops, and McGuire and the gang get out. Now the elephant, he remembers. See, an elephant never forgets. You know that, kids, don't you? Yeah. An elephant remembered that one of those little boys scared him with a mouse. So the elephant turned on the water, gets a nice big spray, and watch what he does. Yeah, he squirts the kids, but hey, wait a minute, elephant, you squirted the wrong boy. Mickey didn't do that, it was Davy Davis. So the elephant says, all right, I'll get him over my head, and he did. And Mickey and the kids had a pretty good circus after all, didn't they? Well, boys and girls, that's the end of our old-time movie for today. Well, now, look, boys and girls, I want you all to be thinking about New Year's resolutions, because this is the day that we make them.
Hey, Buffalo Bob.
Yeah, Ben.
Do you think the kids know what New Year's resolutions are?
Well, I think so, Ben. Do any of you kids know what a New Year's resolution is? Who knows? Well, now, wait a minute. This little fella here. Sonny, what's your name?
Charles.
Charles, what do you think a New Year's resolution is?
Well, I think it is... Well, if you want to do something and you don't get the time to do it, and someday you get the time.
Oh, well, actually, it's a little more than that, Charles. I'll tell you what a New Year's resolution is, kids. It's a promise. A promise that you're going to make about something that you will or will not do during a new year. And you're supposed to keep that promise, no matter how difficult it may be. Right, Ben?
Yes, and believe me, when the year ends, you feel mighty proud if you have kept it.
Ah, yes, sir. As a matter of fact, kid, you know, I remember, on New Year's Day last year, Big Ben promised...
That I would lose 90 pounds by December 31st.
Right.
Well, today is December 31st.
And?
And I've lost 91 pounds.
Well, congratulations, Ben.
Yeah, I lost 81 of them here.
Yeah, and the other 10... Well, say, look, that's Big Ben a year ago. Bearded Ben and Ben today.
Yeah, no beard Ben. That's
Say, your beard must have weighed about 10 pounds, Ben.
That's right.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yes, sir. Bet you feel better, don't you?
Oh, listen, I feel so much better.
Sure.
There's less of me, but all of me is very glad I made that promise and kept it.
Attaboy. Thanks very much. Well, kids, I'm sure that a lot of you boys have made resolutions for the new year. I wonder, have any of you kids made any resolutions for the new year? How about this little girl? Stand up, sweetie. What's your name?
Adrian Grower.
All right, honey. And what resolutions have you made?
Well, one, I hope not to fight with my sister.
Very good.
Two, I'll dry the dishes.
Very good. Every night you're going to dry them?
I do.
Well, that's all right. That's enough, honey. I hope you can keep them. Who else has a resolution? This little fella right here. Stand up. What's your name, Sonny?
Buddy.
What is it, Buddy? How old are you, Buddy?
Six years old.
All right. And what resolutions have you made?
I promised that I wouldn't fight with my friend.
No. Oh, who's your friend?
Erwin.
Do you usually fight with Erwin?
Yes. He makes a lot of fights up with me.
Oh. Well, whose fault is it usually, yours or Irwin's?
I think it's Irwin's.
Oh, and what do you fight about? Things like what?
Like, if I just punch him a little bit, he gives me a big bang.
Oh, you just punch him a little bit and he comes along and bammo, huh? Then what do you do?
And one day we were outside and then we didn't want one of my other friends to see me, and we hid it in the box while it was on the ground.
Well, for heaven's sakes, and you resolve not to fight anymore with Erwin, is that right?
Yes.
All right, that sounds good to me. How about this little fella? Stand up, Sonny. What's your name?
Kenneth Moore.
All right, Kenny, and what have you resolved to do during 1953?
I promise to keep the house cleaner than I do.
Oh, well, that's good. Do you get it dirty now? How do you get it dirty?
With my friends, I wrecked the house.
Oh, I see. Well, all right, kids. Those were all very, very good resolutions. Say, Howdy, what about you? Have you made any resolutions? Oh, well, sure, Buffalo Bob. You see, the princess and Big Ben and I, well, we got together on our resolutions for 1953. And Buffalo Bob, if you'll help us by singing the Howdy Doody Do song, we'll show you. Okay, Howdy. All right, now, first, kids, you've got to pretend that Big Ben is just a little fella. A little fella about my age, just for a minute. And also, let's pretend that the princess is Big Ben's mother.
Okay.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
Okay, and now, gang, let's strike up the band.
Do-do, howdy-doody-do. But don't do a howdy-doody-don't. 'Cause a howdy-doody-do will be good for you, but a howdy-doody-don't won't.
Oh, thanks, Buffalo Bob. And now, kids, these howdy-doody-do's and don'ts are really fun to do. And first, it's early in the morning. When the alarm clock rings in the morning, you're only allowed a half a minute for yawning. Then you get right up and out of bed.
And don't go back to sleep instead.
You crawl right out or fall right out.
But don't make mother call you out.
'Cause if you make her call you out, she's gonna have to bug you out.
And that's not good for mother or you.
So
all get right up and get right out, and that's a howdy doody do. Ah, yes, sir. And then, kids, to get started on a wonderful day, here's what you do. Scrub your hands.
Scrub your hands.
Wash your face.
Wash your face.
Comb your hair.
Comb your hair. Before you get dressed each morning, every day.
Scrub your hands.
Scrub your hands.
Wash your face.
Wash your face.
Comb your hair.
Comb your hair. Before you come down to breakfast, every day.
Your hands are sure to shake hands with someone whose hands are sure to be clean. Your hair is where your face begins, and your face is the very first place to be seen.
Scrub your hands.
Scrub your hands.
Wash your face.
Wash your face.
Comb your hair.
Comb your hair.
Before you go out each morning, every day.
Yes, sir. And then, kids, something most important. Reach for that toothbrush. And, of course,
when you pick
up the brush,
don't be in a rush,
don't rush.
Slowly, carefully brush your teeth in front, in back, on top, beneath. You'll always have clean, healthy teeth.
And you will be glad you did this howdy-doody-doo-doo-doo.
Oh, good going, Howdy. Well, wonderful, Howdy, and thank you very much, Princess.
Oh, it was fun, Buffalo Bob.
Ah, great. And, kids, I thought Big Ben was pretty good, too, didn't you? Yay. Yes, sir,
well,
Big Ben.
It was wonderful.
You know, I think we ought to... Big Ben, I think... Big Ben. Big Ben. Big... Oh, no. He's asleep again. Now he's spoiling all of his New Year's resolutions.
Oh, Buffalo Bob,
yeah?
You forgot that it's still the old year.
Oh, that's right, kid. Sure, sure. Ben will be okay if he wakes up within, about 3 minutes. Because that's when we officially ring in the new year.
Oh, so Buffalo Bob, let him sleep for all the rest of the year 1952. All 3 minutes of it.
Okay, Princess.
And now, kids, the seconds are just ticking away. And soon, every single bell in Dutyville will be ringing in the new year. So, Buffalo Bob, what do you say if we get them started right now?
Oh, right now. I know what we'll do, Mr. Cobb.
Yes, yeah, sir, Buffalo.
Supposing you and I, we try to get all the bells started all over Dutyville.
Oh, fine. Let's
all right.
go.
Now, I'll tell you the way we can do this. Now, we have our Swiss bells here.
Yep.
And do you remember that song, The Bells of St. Mary?
Oh, sure, I remember it.
Well, look, we'll play The Bells of St. Mary, and let's hope that we can make every bell ring out all over Dutyville, okay?
That's just fine.
All right,
let's
come on now. With The Bells of St. Mary. Wonderful.
Oh, it's
boys and girls. Now look, you've all got your noisemakers, haven't you? Now don't make any noise with them, kids, until it's the new year. Now you'll be ready. I'll tell you what we'll do. Big Ben, I want you to sing Auld Lang Syne.
All right, Buffalo.
Oh, wonderful.
Kids, you watch the princess. And when the princess yells Happy New Year, all of you kids all over America yell
Happy New Year, because this is going to be your New Year's Eve.
Oh, that's right.
Meantime, Mr. Cobb, you play the Swiss bells.
Okay.
Princess, you take care of the Happy New Year's.
All right.
Big Ben, you sing Auld Lang Syne, okay?
All right.
Okay.
Now, wait a minute, kids. New Year's is only a few seconds away.
Yeah, about 10 seconds away.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, get ready, kids. Here we go.